I'm Kayla, and welcome to the Patty Morning Show. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Patty Panthers. You may now be seated. Here's today's encore schedule. I hope you have a great day. Now let's go to Mr. Luciotti and see what he has for us today.
What's up, everybody? Good morning. Friday. Boy, we love some Fridays, but we still love you guys in school even more. So we're glad that you are here today, whether it's home, in school, on time. The key is that you are here, ready to rock and roll because your teachers are ready to rock and roll for you. And guess what? We got a sports show this morning. Teddy ball game. Good morning, sir. We got the Looch coming at you with some sports. Teddy ball game, why don't you hit us?
Cannot believe, again, DeLuch, another Friday. We're down to, I believe, three more Fridays after this.
It's amazing. It goes by so fast. That's why we got to grab a hold of every minute that we have and make the absolute most of it, because it'll be over like this.
And the other nice thing is I actually think summer's hitting us this weekend, man. Some 90-degree temperatures this weekend.
Yeah, bring on the heat.
Yeah. Well, in the NBA and NBA basketball news, the Washington Wizards lost to the Boston Celtics, 118-110. Celtics forward Jason Tatum scorched the Wizards. He scored 50 points in the contest. With this win, the Celtics earned the seventh seed in the playoffs, and they're going to face off against the Brooklyn Nets. So that leads me to a question, DeLuch. We got two conferences. We've got the Eastern Conference. We've got the Western Conference. Who do you think is going to come out of the Eastern Conference? We've got the Sixers, Nets, Bucks, Knicks, Hawks, Heat, Celtics. Who do you got, DeLuch?
I'm going with the Sixers on this one. I'm going with the hometown team for you and I, at least our hometown team. Look, but it is the truth. It's not just a hometown pick. This is the best that I felt about the Sixers going into a postseason of any recent years that they've had this kind of team. So I'm definitely going with the Sixers on that one. Out of the West, it's so hard, man. I have no idea. There's some teams that have come up out of nowhere to me. I can't even name some of the people on the team, but it's all about who's coming in the hottest, I think, and who's playing that streak. Yeah. But, you know, I know it's not a sure thing for the Lakers yet, but you can never discount LeBron James and what he can do for a team, and he could single-handedly carry them. But it still requires a team, man. I don't know. What do you think? You pick the Western team. What do you think? You know,
what I would like to see is Sixers-Lakers. I just think, you know, yeah, going back to kind of the old times, you know, back in the day, Sixers-Lakers was a, you know,
Shaq Iverson kind of matchups.
You know, and even before that with Dr. J and all those guys back then and Magic Johnson, I just think it would be really cool to see kind of a real East Coast team in Philly and a real West Coast team in Los Angeles going at it.
So let's make it happen. We can make things happen. We can will it to happen, Teddy ball game.
But DeLuch, we have some more playoffs. We got NHL hockey news. The Washington Capitals and the Boston Bruins split the first two games in their playoff series. How about this one, DeLuch? In game one, Nick Dowd scored the game-winning goal in overtime to lead the Caps to a 3-2 win. But then in game two, Brad Marchand got revenge and scored the game-winning goal in overtime to lead the Bruins to a 4-3 win. So overtime games, big-time clutch moments. We've got some Capitals coming through in game one, some Bruins coming through in game two. Should be a pretty interesting series moving forward.
Yeah, man. And you can say what you will. I don't watch a lick of hockey all year long, but I will watch some hockey playoffs, particularly the Capitals. And you can say what you want, boys and girls, but man, their hockey playoffs is pretty awesome. And whenever game's coming down to overtime like that, single goal difference is pretty cool.
And we're starting to get a little bit along here in the Major League Baseball. The Washington Nationals did fall short against the Chicago Cubs 6-3. David, I hope it's Boti, hit a two-run home run for the Cubbies, and the Nationals were unable to mount a comeback. The Philadelphia Phillies, they beat the Miami Marlins 8-2. The Phillies were losing 3-1 going into the eighth inning, but then the offense came alive. scoring 7 runs to secure the win. And that's what I always love about baseball, DeLuch. No time limit. You just play until that last out.
And Teddy Ballgame is what I love about my Phillies this year, our Phillies this year. They are never out of it, and they're playing a ton of one-run games. You know, they have a ton of people on the injured list, not playing right now, ton of their starters. So you have bench guys that are coming through, and I know a number of them came through in that particular game in that big eight-run inning to come behind and come from behind and win. I hate to tell you, Nationals fans, but that's the difference between those two teams. So, but no, it's awesome, man. It's awesome. We're going to love it.
And last, we've got MLS soccer news. DC United did win a match against the Chicago Fire Football Club, 1-0, but then they dropped their next match against Orlando City Soccer Club, 1-0. So not a lot of scoring going on. DC United still having a little bit of trouble here at the beginning of the year. Hopefully they can get it going as the year goes on.
Yeah, season will get fired up. It's somewhat of a long season, not quite like baseball, but hey, anything can happen. They're still pretty fun and exciting games. So I hope you guys are, I know a lot of you guys are watching soccer. So hopefully you guys are watching throughout the summer too. Hey man, sports, it's all about competing. It's all about you against yourself and bringing out your best all the time. It's about never stop believing in yourself and believing in your team and helping your team rise up, because you alone can't do it. You need your team. So there's some great lessons. So boys and girls, bring it your best today. You know, don't feel defeated after one loss. There's always a new day. Help your team, your class rise up and be the best that you can be. Gotta love it. Go have a great Friday. Teddy Ballgame, you do the same thing. Boys and girls, we could do this together, because together we are Patty Strong. Let's go.